What is up, my peeps? Tony Rex up in here yet once again. Not because I want to, because trust me, I do not want to, guys. I was retired from this game, done with it. But with the no proc changes and, you know, changes to the CP system and all of that, you know, I was looking at it, seeing what was going on with ESO, and, you know, they got some attractive, interesting changes. So, anyways, and it's like the once great Apicino once said, you know, you guys know I like this phrase, you know, they try to get out, and they pull me back in. So, you know, the freaking game does it again, they pull me back in. So, let's go quickly into the build. This guy's to, before I go into anything else, this is for Battlegrounds, okay? You guys have seen me in the past, the ones that, you know, and like I've always said, I'm not trying to be a big YouTuber. I come out sporadically, maybe once or twice a year, I'll do another video with family, work, and other stuff going on, just life. I just don't have the time now. So, I just started playing a week ago, so I'm still very rusty. I will show the build and gameplay at the end, of course. And I'm not going to edit the gameplay to make myself look good either. I'm just going to go, I'm going to give you guys a whole round from beginning all the way to end to show you what it's like to play this build in a full round of Battlegrounds and how, and again, consider that I just been back for a week. I know I'm a day one VR14 player, old school, but still, you know, it's kind of muscle memory, but still, I haven't played in 7 months, 7, 8 months. So I'm just coming back after a week, still could improve, do better. Also, as far as the, you know, the body pieces or jewelry, I could yellow something here, transmute something there, so it can still have room for improvement. But let's go quickly into it. These are the numbers on buff. I will be buffing up in a second here. So we're still Dark Elf. Vampire Stage 2, I will explain that in a second, more in depth. When you come out of Hidden, y'all know that that gives you a little boost, okay, in spell power. We got the Atronach for recovery. We're still rocking Ice Cream, consumable. And we got that event going on, but that's irrelevant, right? So, let's buff up real quick. This is what I use. You can also use Essence Spell Power. You can also use the Cyrodiil ones. I go with those as well, the Magpots. So, let's buff up really quickly here and show you the numbers as they look when coming out of Hidden. So, I am so sorry. I did not... Yeah, never mind. Oh my god, let's do that again. I didn't pop the consumable, the pot. I am so sorry for that, guys. Alrighty. 4,200 spell damage, basically. Almost 2,900 magicka recovery. Maximum magicka 36. Maximum health 18. Maximum stamina 16. That should be enough. On the back bar, for some reason, I do hit 20k. So, I don't know. But on the max health. But you should be good. We play around with the shields. So, and then the you know, the penetration is really good. Now, let's go into the... What I'm using, we're still using, of course, Calurium, guys. This is nasty. Remember, this is for Battlegrounds. This is a proc set, so you don't want to be using this for Cyrodiil. For Cyrodiil, I am using my Magicka Dragonite. I'm building a Magicka Dragonite right now. And that has a lot to do with this build, and I'll explain why. Okay, so we're using Calurium. Sharpen on the main bar. Spell damage glyph. I sometimes could rock poisons on the back bar, but I'm not. I'm just using Restoration Staff of Eternal Yokita, guys. Infused with a mag damage and restorery. I'm sorry, recovery, you know, basically the restore 443 magicka glyph. You can put whatever poisons, you can even use whatever, you know, resto staff. I'm just using Yokita for extra 4% healing, you know what I'm saying? Now, Balrog is out, Falcon Scoria is back. I'm using this one. We got, I'm just using Infuse and Divines. Just go according to how you prefer, guys. Some people use all Divines. I'm using Infuse with the Triglyph on the big pieces like head, you know, chest, and legs. Everything else, light and divines. Now, Calurian, y'all know what that does. That's been a nasty set that I've been using since it came out. Since day one, Calurian, I've always been using it. I love it for PvP. One of my favorites. Until they ruin it completely, I'm still going to rock it. Now, it's more limited to Battlegrounds because, of course, no proc Cyrodiil situation right now. But it's still a very good set in Battlegrounds. Very nasty. You will get some hate mill, trust me. So spell critical, damage critical, and then the fifth bonus. Y'all know what it does. Calurian is not a new set. It's been around for a little bit. Falcon Scoria, that spell penetration. Then you got the, you know, the little comet that comes down. What's the other set, Tony? Is it still Amberplasm? Unfortunately not, guys, and I'll tell you why. I love Amberplasm. There's nothing wrong with it. If you have, if you can, the thing with Amberplasm is that I pass it on to my Magicka Decay. And that's what's affecting my Magicka Nightblade, that because I need it from my Magicka Decay, because of Magicka Decay, you need that sustain at all times. Amberplasm is just there all the times. Bloodthorn, look what it does. Damage, Magicka, Magicka Recovery, the fifth bonus, you restore it when you deal direct damage. On a Nightblade, when you come out of stealth and you're doing that burst, you do your combo, immediately you're getting this Magicka and Stamina back. So with the Magicka Nightblade, it feels better. The Bloodthorn feels way better in a Magicka Nightblade. So I would say it's back. You can use it very good, again, for Battlegrounds, guys, not for Cyrodiil. Everything is just basically Triglyph and Magicka, mostly Infused Divines. And then I got this I want to transmute to Infuse for the Magicka Recovery. And then these two spell damage with one of them, Bloodthirsty. Let's go into the skills, guys. Impale, you execute. Dampen Magicka, I know they nerf, from what I noticed, they nerf the shields a little bit, but I'm still using them. If you know how to play around it, you'll still be good, guys. Inner Light for the passives, for the Mage's Guild. And also, you know, that increased 5% Major Prophecy. Flame Clench, even though we're not using the DSA Flame Staff, still good. That's part of the combo. Merciless Resolve, y'all know what that is by now. And Shooting Star, this is great with the combo that, you know, that you do with the Magicka Nightblade coming from stealth, and I'll explain that in a second. Siphoning Attacks, keep your sustain up. Shadow Disguise, needless to say. Conceal Weapon for mobility. Mass Hysteria for the old crap moment. When you're getting 1VX or whatever. Race Against Time, I do not like Channel Acceleration, the cast time. I like to be constantly moving. Something that's quick, not with a cast time. Also, Life Giver, that would be... I apologize, what the heck is this? Man, YouTube be... Okay, there goes the music again. Sorry guys for that. Life Giver, this is your real, like, oh crap moment when you need to... You know, but I wouldn't recommend using this unless highly needed, guys, because you want to be... You know, using your Shooting Star. So, the way it goes is, the combo, you buff yourself completely up, okay? You buff yourself completely up, everything, and then pop your... So it's basically heavy attack from hitting, you hit the person, heavy attack, flame clench, light attack, impale. That would be the combo. With the ultimate, preferably with the ultimate, you shoot Shooting Star. I mean, I'm not in front of a dummy, so I can't do it right now. But you do Shooting Star, basically. You shoot the comet, right, your ultimate, so it will be ultimate, light attack, flaming clench, so what happens is, before they can even block or react, the comet is hitting him at the same time that your flame clench is stunning them back, so let your flame clench be the one that stuns them back, so you can get that combo. Now, if you have your Merciless Resolve already charged up, I will shoot it right in there. Most of the time, guys, unless they're a tank, everybody will be one-shotted. It's a nasty, or I mean one-shotted, like, they'll die within that combo. Within that sequence, one sequence, right? Not like one shot per se, but, you know, so, and then you just gotta recharge your Kalurin up, you know, for 10 seconds, and in the meantime, just, you know, get a couple of hits in there. But anyways, it is a very successful build. I've been enjoying playing around with it. I will show you some gameplay now, and hopefully, you know, it works out for you guys as well. Again, it's not highly edited. It's just from point one all the way to the end. So you will see how this build works realistically in a Battlegrounds scenario. All right, till next time, guys. Take it easy. One, two, three.